I'm going to show you how to make your wild overlapping water lines look neat and tidy using two simple steps. There's a really convenient way of making water lines using the offset effect for your land layer, but you may find that the result looks more like a spaghetti nightmare than beautiful coastal ripples. The first thing you're gonna wanna check is if your layer is single part or multi-part. Single part means each island is its own distinct feature. Each geometric ring is its own thing. Multi-part means that each of those little geometric rings are all just part of the same big multi-parted feature. You can tell if a feature is multi-part when if you select any one part of it, all of the other rings are selected right along with. And when it comes to water lines, you want your polygons to be multi-part. Here's how to convert single part to multi-part. We need to dissolve all of these separate shapes into one shape. So I'll fire up the pairwise dissolve tool. I'll feed it my single part land layer. And then when it comes to the data attribute that I'd want to dissolve by, I'll just leave it blank so everything gets dissolved. And lastly, make sure create multiple features is active because like that's what we're here for. And a quick test to verify that we do indeed have a glorious amalgamated polygon. Yes, we're on to step two. And the second of our two steps has to do with the trade-off between performance and perfection. We're after perfection. So let's take a look at the symbology for this layer, and we're gonna use that handy trick of the offset effect for our stroke. If I increase it, the stroke renders outside of the polygon's edge. But they just trip over each other willy-nilly, overlapping all over the place. So I'm gonna change the offset option from fast to accurate. And it's gonna take a little bit longer, but the robot is being smart about where it draws these offsets so they don't overlap with each other. And the result is nice harmonious water lines without any self-intersections. And of course, one water line is gonna be lonely, so we'll give it some friends, duplicating this layer and increasing the offset distance each time. And we end up with handsome, charming water lines that don't step on each other, don't overlap, and have the benefit of having a visual distance, so scale doesn't matter. It's always gonna look good.